China's African safari hits a major bump as Kenya rejects its BRI project. China has gotten another jolt out of the blue as a Kenyan appellate court has passed a judgment against the $3.2 billion standard gauge railway project between the Kenyan government and the China Road and Bridge Corporation, calling the contract illegal. The Kenyan High Court had earlier rejected the petition, but the appellate court took cognizance of the plea and gave out the verdict. The petition said that the railway cargo project was a 100% Kenyan-funded venture with the Kenyan taxpayers who would be repaying the loan payments. The lawsuit was first filed in 2014 when the project was still under construction, and a decision has come after 6 years when large sections of the railway line are already operational, with both parties having poured massive resources into the project. And this railway line has shot up costs by 50%. And if you thought this railway line was going to help the people of Kenya, it has shot up costs by 50%. The newly built Chinese railway line from the port city of Mombasa to the capital Nairobi has shot up the cost of transportation by 50%. China built the railway line under its ambitious Belt and Road Initiative. The businessmen continue to transport goods through trucks because the railway line is 50% costlier. The Kenyan government has made it mandatory to transport the goods through the railway line, and this is hurting the profits of businessmen. Daniel Manduku, head of the state-run Kenya Ports Authority, says, "The KPA has an obligation to feed the railway. We were the guarantors of the rail." Kenya is one of China's largest trade partners in Africa, holding 11.55% of Kenya's foreign loans valued at around $6.5 billion. Worryingly, China's interest payments represent 87% of the cash used to service debt expenditure in 2019. In fact, Kenya is so debt-ridden that its Mombasa port is under threat now. If Kenya fails to repay huge loans advanced by Chinese lenders, then it risks losing the lucrative Mombasa port. The loans were granted for the development of the standard gauge railway project, which has been deemed illegal by the appellate court. The terms of a $2.3 billion loan for Kenya Railways Corporation specify that the port's assets are collateral and they are not protected by Kenya's sovereign immunity due to a waiver in the contract. Mombasa is not just a gateway into Kenya, but also into its landlocked neighboring nations like Burundi, the Democratic Republic of Congo, Rwanda, South Sudan, and Uganda. Therefore, losing it means losing sovereignty over the nation, in a sense. China's influence is increasing in the African region, and in September 2018, Zambia even lost the Kenneth Kaunda International Airport to China over debt repayment. Mombasa could be the next casualty of China's debt trap diplomacy. The Hambantota port is a living example of the same. The Hambantota project was one of the biggest reasons why Indo-Sri Lanka ties had deteriorated considerably towards the end of Mahinda Rajapaksa's presidential term. The project had failed to kick off, and after failing to show commitment in the payment of billions of dollars in loans to China, a debt-ridden Sri Lanka had to ultimately hand over the port on a 99-year lease term to China. In fact, the debt trap diplomacy of China is the bedrock of the Belt and Road Initiative. The modus operandi of China is fairly simple. Enter a country on the pretext of developmental activities, hand out fishy loans with exorbitant interest rates, and when the state fails to repay them, capture the territories, buy off members of the government and the media, and before the people know it, China has colonized the entire state. In this context, it is heartening to see Kenya stand up for its own sovereignty. The appellate court's decision might just allow the Kenyan government to come out of the Chinese sinkhole of debt trap.